Lisa Breck.
Steve Edwards.
You are with the good doctor.
I am.
And he has some important information.
Hello, doctor.
Hello.
You'll be seeing him in a moment. We're actually going to do like a little bit of a setup for him, Steve. Ooh. Big time here. You know what? Nothing about this sounds like fun, I know, but getting a colonoscopy detects about and removes 98% of colorectal tumors and can reduce the risk of getting colon cancer by 70%. So with that in mind, the Lapeer Surgery Center held what's called Scope Fest this weekend.
The purpose of a colonoscopy is to remove colon polyps that we know can progress to become colon cancer. So when we remove them in these early stages, or even detect colon cancer in an early stage during a screening colonoscopy, we can prevent death from colon cancer, which is the goal.
So this is this big event that you were at this weekend, right, Dr. A? And these guys were very serious, and it is a very serious issue, but you had a lot of fun with it this weekend, right?
We did, you know, and this is National Colorectal Cancer Awareness Month, and we just wanted to spread the word and let people know that it's not as bad as people think it is,
Has that become such a myth that it's just the prep is so horrific?
Yeah, I mean, you know, the prep, the idea of having a colonoscopy, you know, just the whole concept. And so, you know, often we are criticized that we don't taste what we give to people.
So you guys all did this?
Yes. So the idea was that, you know, we're going to do it, and we're going to let people know that it's okay, it's not that bad. So we actually had a party the night before, and we had, you know, we were mixing.
You're like a mixologist.
They're making
like Gatorade drinks with all the stuff that makes you spend the rest of the day in the bathroom.
So you have to mix this laxative with some sort of drink. Mm-hmm. So we had all these different mixers, and the idea was that we'll do it together, so that it's a fun event and everybody can see that it's not as bad as they think it is.
Okay.
And then the next morning, we all, you know, I didn't have a colonoscopy because I was part of the, you know, team there. But, 14 people had colonoscopies that day, doctors and nurses, to show that this is something that can really save lives.
Because this is the second leading cause of cancer deaths, correct?
It is the second leading cause of deaths, and it's preventable. So if you have a colonoscopy, and the guidelines are at 50, you should have your first colonoscopy.
Unless
A, you have a history of colon cancer, then it should be younger, at 40 or 10 years before your relative had the cancer. If you're African American, it's 45. Mm-hmm. And, you know, there are certain conditions where you can't have it. For example, if you had Crohn's disease or ulcerative colitis, these are conditions where you can't really do a colonoscopy.
But there's another little thing you can do called...
Correct. So you can swallow this pill that actually has a camera that can actually look at things in your bowel. It's not as good as the colonoscopy, but the idea is to let people know that you can save not only your lives, but lives of people you love if you get them to a colonoscopy.
And if you do it, you don't have to do it every year. It's once every 10 years, and why is that?
It's once, because the progression of the disease is not that quick. So if you didn't have a polyp or a precancerous lesion at 10 years, the likelihood is very low that you would have it before 10 years. So every 10 years, get your colonoscopy, save some lives.
And that's what's amazing is that late stage, it can do this great job of detection and saving lives, even if it's gone on and then you finally get yourself.
Yes, and the reason to do a colonoscopy and not a CAT scan or an MRI is that when you do the colonoscopy, you can actually biopsy it. You can actually remove some of these early tumors, and I think that really helps in diagnosis and also prevention.
Okay, great. Dr. Ahluwalia, so go get your colonoscopy. Steve, that sounds like fun.
Well, Steve, have you had yours?
Of course I have. I'd say there are mornings here where I feel like I'm having it. yes. No. I never. It wasn't a big deal. Even the prep wasn't that terrible.
Is it just that it's been made up into such a big thing in everyone's mind?
And then they give you the propofol, and then boy, everything's fine.
Yeah, you don't know that.
It is so comfortable that when you wake up, you think, did they really do anything, or they just gave me the propofol? I fell asleep, and then I woke up again.
Right. So there you go. Please.
Steve. Listen to Steve.
If Steve can have it done, then everybody can have it done.
Now, Dr. Ahluwalia.
Yes.
For the third week.
I know the coffee. No, Steve. No. Okay, I asked. Are we doing the coffee thing?
Okay. Yeah. This deserves a whole segment. So let's wait and let's do it the next time.
Next Monday.
With a breakdown of everything about coffee, good coffee, bad, the confusion.
Yes. I drink coffee, so you know, I want to know myself.
Okay, great. All right, you will do all the research.
Only do it if you have good news about coffee.
Yeah, coffee. Can we have it in large quantities?
Well, it's good and it's bad, but overall it's good.
We'll save it for next week, Steve.
Yes.
You promise now.
I promise now.
Okay, all right, thank you. Either that or you're getting a colonoscopy.
We're not
putting you under. All right, thank you, Dr.
All right, guys, take care.